Hi everyone, I made another tutorial on how to trace the motion in video using iClone. This time, I included some basic settings and steps that my master forgot to include in the last tutorial. Firstly guys, let's create a new project. Then import the video that you want to trace and set as a background and guide for our motion trace. Then, just drag and drop the video into your project. Remember to choose a video with front view only. Now that the video is in our project, the dancer will be my dance instructor for this tutorial. Bring your model into 3D space. Now guys, I will pick myself because I love to dance. Press F to switch to front view and hide the grid by pressing the Ctrl G in your keyboard. Now go to Modify tab panel and check the foot contact. Now open the project setting window panel by clicking this small icon here or by pressing the Ctrl, Shift, and P together in your keyboard. Let's adjust the total frames based on the length of the video. Now open the timeline window. Activate the object-related track by pressing this icon. But do not activate the auto extend. Auto extend will merge the motion clip automatically. We don't want that because we should assign transition curve to our motion clip first before we merge the clips together. Now open the motion layer editor. Go to bone setting and set the opacity to 0 to hide the bone of our model. Now that everything is set, I am ready to follow the movements and the steps of our dancer. Now guys, please watch the rest of the video and follow the process step by step. Or grab a popcorn or snack and relax while watching this video. For the meantime, do not create or assign any camera, and keep this setting. By the way guys, before I forget, please use the keying mode feature, since in the previous tutorial my master was lazy to use that features. This will help us to control the body parts of our model easily and to lessen the dislocation of the bones during the process. Guys, always use the keyboard shortcuts keys or hotkeys. I put the list in the description portion below. Just to inform you guys, the clip that we are using now is from the old project of my master. I decided to cut the clip from there and use it here just to save the time also. Because as he said in previous tutorial, the process is time consuming. He started this project last October 2021 and he just completed on the second week of January 2022. What? Maybe because of his other job also. So if you noticed a different setting here compared to what I said, please ignore them. We can also use the hand gestures in the Content Manager under Template of Animation tab. We have many options there to use. If you noticed the two primitive boxes, I just put those boxes so I can remember where the feet of the model is located. Don't forget to use the keying mode, guys. Switch to body parts if you are moving the body parts only. Okay guys, if you already got an idea, please go to track 1030 to 1045 of the video. You will see there when is the best part to reset the motion clip. Because sometimes we need our model to reset back to default clip pose to fix those dislocated bones during the process. Here guys, here, look for the frame where our dancer changed her root position. My suggestion is every time the dancer jump and reaches the peak point. Then, go to the motion layer editor and press the reset button to reset our model to the default T pose. Now that our model is back to her default T pose, we also fixed those bones that are dislocated during the process. I will make a separate video for this topic, guys. Guys, I will end the tutorial here. I hope you learned something. If you like the tutorial, please share it. Thanks for watching. See you in my next video. Stay safe.